Controversial Sandigan Bayan Justice Gregory Ong was sacked from the judiciary in 2014 following the revelation of his supposed ties with pork barrel scam queen Janet Lim Napoles. Ong was accused of allegedly fixing the malversation of funds case against Napoles in connection with the purchase of more than 3 million pesos worth of Kevlar helmets in 1998. The helmets were supposed to come from the United States, but they were actually manufactured in Taiwan. The Sandigan Bayan acquitted Napoles in 2010, but in 2013, in the midst of the Priority Development Assistance Fund or PDAF scam, two former aides of Napoles revealed Ong was Napoles' contact at the Antigraft Court. That's why Napoles was confident she would get away with the malversation case. In 2013, a photo of Ong with Napoles and former Senator Jinggoy Estrada was published on news website Rappler. Both Estrada and Napoles would eventually end up facing plunder charges. In its investigation, the Supreme Court said that although there was no sufficient evidence of corruption or bribery on the part of Ong, the totality of circumstances of Ong's association with Napoles showed his corrupt inclinations, which gave cause for the public to doubt his honesty and fairness in handling the Kevlar case and the integrity of the courts. Ong was the chair of the Sandigan Bayan Division, which acquitted Napoles. The court also found out Ong lied when he did not disclose in his letter to the Chief Justice that he had gone to Napoles' office, even if this took place after her acquittal. The High Court dismissed Ong from service, stripped him of retirement benefits, and barred him from ever holding public office. But after 6 years, the same court partially granted Ong's plea to be able to receive his pension as a measure of mercy. His disqualification from being employed in any government office was also lifted. In the resolution penned by Associate Justice Marvick Leonen, Ong supposedly showed remorse and submitted testimonies showing he rendered free legal service and was active in social civic activities. The court also considered his medical status with the recurrence of his prostate cancer and his need to undergo treatment. Even then, the court said the gravity of his deeds should not be disregarded. That's why it chose to forfeit 2/3 of his lump sum retirement benefit as penalty. The High Court reminded Ong not to waste the second chance he has been given. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.